A dangerous virus is spreading rapidly in China, and U.S. officials are very worried that it could come here. Coronavirus, it's called, which produces pneumonia-like symptoms. Three people have already died from this illness, which has spread to at least three other Asian countries.
There's a new virus spreading throughout China, known as COVID-19, or more commonly referred to as the coronavirus. Scientists are saying this could be the next global pandemic.
My administration will take all necessary steps to safeguard our citizens from this threat.
The first case of the deadly Chinese coronavirus making its way to the U.S.
The U.S. has its first cases of coronavirus up in Washington State. As the stock market begins to crash, the president assures us this is not something to worry about.
When you have 15 people, and the 15 within a couple of days is going to be down to close to zero, that's a pretty good job we've done.
There are now more than 80,000 confirmed cases in the U.S., just shy of the numbers in China and Italy, and more than 1,100 people have died.
Now, the virus that we're talking about having to do, you know, a lot of people think that goes away in April with the heat. Now the Democrats are politicizing the coronavirus, and this is their new hoax.
As the death toll rises, many states are now implementing shelter-in-place rules. This coming as the U.S. becomes the world leader in number of cases of the virus.
To unleash the full power of the federal government in this effort today, I am officially declaring a national emergency.
A food fight broke out. You can see in this video an employee and a 15-year-old customer began throwing items at each other. Thankfully, no one was hurt. The store says it is cooperating with police. Was that a head of lettuce? Did I see a head of lettuce?
Why do I want to get in on this so bad?
Oh, wow. Whoa, whoa, that's fruit juice. Ketchup or fruit juice?
The U.S. has placed a national curfew on its citizens, as well as enacting a law prohibiting any gathering of more than 10 people in any public area.
Tensions flared at Woolworth's Chillora around 7 o'clock this morning when three women became involved in a toilet paper tussle.
I just want one pack.
No, not one pack.
Well, Bill, it's still going on. This thing started at around 11 o'clock this morning, and it shows no signs of stopping. They wanted to clog the streets here, and that's exactly what they're doing. They're sending a message to Governor Gretchen Whitmer that they don't agree with her stay-at-home order. They say it goes too far, takes away their rights, and in some cases is too arbitrary.
It's going to disappear. One day it's like a miracle. It will disappear. And from our shores, it could get worse before it gets better. It could maybe go away. We'll see what happens. Nobody really knows.
Breaking news, the president signs an executive order sending military aid to major U.S. cities. This is most cities have now reached a state of anarchy while facing this coronavirus pandemic. For more on this, we turn to Brian.
Thanks, Tom. As you can see, many states have now reached an all-time high in their level of crimes. This coming as the corona pandemic worsens, having the highest death toll in the U.S. I'm just scared.
Hey, girl.
Are you now just watching this apocalypse unfold in front of us?
You really shouldn't be watching the news. They always blow things out of proportion.
It's easy for you to say.
All right, I get that you're immunocompromised or whatever, but that doesn't mean you should live your life in fear.
All right, I'll talk to you later.
We'll be right back.
retro aerobics time, a fun-filled, fat-burning workout. So do the best you can, and let's get started. Just march in place, that's it. It's a fun workout. We're gonna begin with the step touch. Ready, just step touch, that's it. Good, get down low, really feel it, that's it. Now, let's begin the arm, remove the top, that's great. Just do the best that you can, you got it. Now, wrap with the waist on, wrap the waist.
You can just put that down right there. I'll get it later.
You can just put it down right there, please.
Oh, hey, I'm sorry about that. Hey, I'm sorry.
Okay. Oh, my.
Hey.
Oh, my. No, stop.
Now, I would like to remind you, Carol, that you are the one who spent $94,000 to buy animals to fill your so-called sanctuary. You still have them there at your facility, you're still tagging them as rescues, and you're still frauding the public.
I believe that I sold Don and Carol Lewis their very first tiger in 1995. They flew their private plane up to Shelbyville, and then I met them. They seemed to be good people. Scrappy was his name. He was a
there's a man, and I think he's trying to break into my house. Well, please hurry!
Out.
Please, please, please.
A Jew.
Weird dream.
Yeah, you're telling me.